Hello everyone, today we are going to perform an experiment called characteristics of lamp. In this experiment, we will obtain the VA characteristics of the two different types of lamps. First one lamp is rated with 40 volts and 220 volts. It is operated with AC, that is a tungsten lamp. The second lamp is 18 watts and 220 volts AC supply, and it is a compact fluorescent lamp, that is CFL lamp. Okay, so first of all, to perform this experiment we required some operators. First of all, we required auto transformer to get the variable voltage. It is a range of 0 to 230 volts. Second operator is ammeter to measure the current, which is type of MI instrument, the range 0 to 2 amperes. We required one more voltmeter, that is 0 to 300 volts. It is MI, quantity is required is 1. So basically we are performing on the lamps, so we require two lamps. First one is an incandescent lamp, second one is a CFL lamp. So this is the circuit diagram to perform this experiment. So first of all, this is neutral. So this is neutral, this is phase. So from this we will get a 230 volts of supply from the mains. So this is called DPST, means dipole single thrown switch, okay, to isolate the entire circuit from the supply. So this is fuse of rating 5 amperes to protect the electrical appliances. So this is single phase auto transformer. Okay, so this is the voltmeter of MI type, 0 to 300 volts to measure the supply voltage. So it is connected across the auto transformer. Okay, so from the voltmeter, first terminal is connected to the ammeter first terminal. It is a range of 0 to 2 amperes. So ammeter second terminal is connected to the tungsten lamp having the around 40 watts. Okay, so bulb second terminal is connected to the CFL lamp second terminal. From the first terminal of the lamp is connected to the second terminal of the ammeter. So this ammeter measures the current through the CFL lamp. This ammeter is measure the current flowing through the tungsten lamp. Okay, so we need to follow the some procedure to perform this experiment. First of all, choose the appropriate rating of the ammeter and voltmeter and fuse wire. Second step is connect the circuit diagram as per the circuit. Keep the switches S is open, and first of all see the auto transformer is zero position or not. Okay, if it is not in zero position, please make sure that keep it a zero position. Okay, now close the switch, increase the auto transformer output voltage in steps of either 20 volts or 30 volts until reach the full voltage, that is 230 volts. It is also called rated voltage. At each step, note down the voltage V1 and ammeter reading A1 and A2. Okay, and record them in a tabular form. Repeat this procedure in decreasing order also. Observe the light glowing or dimness in the light. Okay, after performing the experiment, keep the auto transformer, make sure that a zero position, by decreasing the voltage in steps of 20 or 30 volts. Okay, so this is the observation table. So this is the voltage 140, 80, and 120 are 160, 200, and 230 volts. So we calculated current through the tungsten lamp as well as a CFL lamp. It is shows in the first column of the current is increasing order level. Okay. This is a decreasing, means if the voltage from 230 to 200, 200 to 160, decreasing order also we will measure the currents. So we will calculate the mean of these two currents, and average is written in this column. Similar manner, CFL bulb also experiment is performed. Now we will draw the, this is the model graph for the lamp 1 and lamp 2. We will get a non-linear curve because of these two lamps or non-linear characters. Okay, so by considering on the x-axis is voltage and y-axis is current, we will get the complete characteristic of the VI, both the lamps.
Hello everyone, here we have performed an experiment to verify the VI characteristics of the tungsten and fluorescent lamp. So the connections are made on the circuit as like the circuit diagram. In the panel, here it is the circuit breaker. So it is the DSPAC. So this indicator shows the supply is on or off. If the indicator is shows red color, the supply is on. The DPSP is help to close the circuit to in order to give the supply to the auto transformer. This is the auto transformer to supply the entire circuit with step. The auto transformer is calibrated as in steps of 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, up to 270 volts. So by varying this wheel, we can vary the supply voltage. So the first initial condition, this is the voltmeter to measure the, these two ammeter connected in series with the each lamp to measure the current flowing through each lamp. Okay. Voltmeter. This is the voltmeter to measure the voltage. These two ammeter connected in series with the each element to measure the current through the each lamp.
Right.
The connections. Circuit diagram. The voltmeter positive is connected to the ammeter. Auto transformer positive terminal. The negative is connected to the auto terminal, negative terminal. So this is the phase, this is neutral. Okay. Here in the voltmeter, here it is having the three terminals. So one is 300, one is 150, this is the common. So if we connect it to 300 terminal, so the meter is calibrated up to 150. So in order to calculate the voltage, the multiplying factor is 2. So whatever the value we got in the meter into 2, if we connected terminal to 300 terminal. In ammeter, the connection made terminal of the tungsten lamp is connected to the ammeter 1 terminal. This is positive. The negative terminal is connected to the auto negative terminal. Similar way, NCFL lamp also connected, positive is connected to the positive terminal. The another common terminal is connected to the common terminal. The tungsten lamp positive terminal is connected to the ammeter, and negative terminal is connected to the neutral of the auto transformer. Similar manner, CFC lamp also connected same fashion. Means positive terminal is connected to the positive, the negative terminal is connected to the common terminal, which is negative terminal. While giving the connection, we must take care of the voltmeter ammeter connection While connecting the voltmeter, ammeter, we must take care of the voltmeter must be connected in parallel, the ammeter must be connected in the series of the connection. So now let us switch on the circuit breaker. So we will observe the power on in the indicator. It shows the red color. So now I am switching on the DPST. We get the power supply. So auto transformer shows red color indicator, means which is on. Slowly, now I am wiring the auto transformer from initial position to the rated value. So slowly we can observe the lamp brightness as well as ammeter and voltmeter readings. So increase the auto transformer value up to 230, means it is the rated value. So 230, so we can clearly see the reading of the voltmeter, which shows 115, because we connected the terminal of 300. Here it is multiplication factor is 2. So note down the corresponding readings of voltmeter, ammeter for each lamp, means tungsten lamp as well as CFL lamps. So now slowly decrease the with the steps of 10 or 20, we can measure the corresponding readings of the voltmeter as well as ammeter for each step. So we can clearly observe the dimness of the lamps while decreasing the voltage. Gradually decrease up to zero. Note on the corresponding radius, draw the behavior characteristics of each lamp. Thank you.
Hello student. Today experiment is called a fluorescent lamp. In this experiment, we will obtain a VI characteristic of the fluorescent lamp. So in order to perform this experiment, we required some operators. So first of all, we required an auto transformer of the rating 0 to 230 volts to get the variable voltage. Second operator is ammeter. It is rating is 0.02 volts. A type of ammeter, we required 2 in quantity. The voltmeter also we required to measure the voltage of the range of 0 to 300 volts and 0 to 150 volts of MI type. So fluorescent lamp also required, that is the rating of 36 watt. So to perform this experiment, connection made as per the circuit diagram. Okay, this is the single phase supply, this is the phase and this is a neutral. So this is the DPST switch. Okay, DPST means dipole a single thrown switch. This is a 5 ampere fuse to protect the entire network from the over currents. So this is a single phase transformer. From the single phase transformer we will get the variable voltage. So this is the first voltmeter across the transformer. To measure the supply voltage is a choke coil. So first voltmeter, first terminal is connected to the choke of the first terminal, and choke second terminal is connected to the ammeter of the first terminal. So this is the current measured through this network. From this we are connecting a fluorescent lamp. Ammeter second terminal is connected to the first terminal of the fluorescent lamp. Here it is, second terminal is connected to the common point, that is neutral. Okay, here it is, the voltmeter is connected across the choke coil to measure the voltage across the choke coil. Here it also a voltmeter is connected across the fluorescent lamp. Okay, it is of the rating 0 to 150 volts. So here it is 0 to 300 volts. In order to perform this experiment, you need to follow a standard procedure. Set up the circuit as shown in figure. Keep the switches S is open. Okay. With the auto transformer at zero output position, close the switch. Yes. Okay. Third one is increase the auto transformer output gradually until the light lights up. Okay. The lamp lights up. Note the meter readings and enter them in the proper column in the tablet form, which is given below. So when the lamp starts glow, increase the auto transformer output voltage in steps until the rated voltage is obtained. So enter the readings of the meters in tablet form 3. So it is also given in the below. So decrease the supply voltage in step until the lamp extinguishes. Record the meter readings. Okay. So this is the tablet form to measure the, to note down the voltage and current values. This is the supply voltage, first column, the first column, the supply voltage. The second one is the voltage across the load, that is voltage across the lamp. This is the choke coil voltage. This is the IL, the current through the network. So remarks, in the remarks we will note down the lamp is a full bright or low bright or dim. Okay, that is the remark we need to note down. With this, the experiment is over.
Hello everyone, here we are to perform to observe the VI characteristics of the fluorescent lamp. Okay, this is the variac, this is the voltmeter, this is the ammeter, these are the voltmeters. This variac is used to increase the supply from 0 to rated voltage. This voltmeter measures the supply voltage, which is connected in parallel to the supply voltage. This is the ammeter connected in series to the entire network to measure the flow of current. This voltmeter connected across the choke. This voltmeter connected across the fluorescent lamp. This is the MCB. We need to get the supply from this. So switch on the power supply. This is the on position. So here we are observing the auto transform at zero position, gradually increasing the voltage till the fluorescent lamp glows. So now the fluorescent lamp is glowed at a particular voltage, that is around 220 volts. This is the current flows through the entire network, that is around more than 0.35 amperes. This is the voltage across the choke coil. This is the voltage across the fluorescent lamp. So now we slowly increase the voltage. We can observe the glow in the fluorescent lamp. Note down the corresponding voltage and current values.
Apply at the 260 volt.
This is the voltage 190 volts. So gradually increase in steps of 10. This is the 200 voltage. So current is measured around 0.25 amperes. The voltage across the choke is around 0. The voltage across fluorescent lamp is around 55 volts. Now gradually increase the voltage. It is 105 into 2, means it is 210 volts. The current in the network is around 0.29 amperes. The voltage across the choke is 0. The voltage across the fluorescent lamp is 55 volts. It is around 110 volts. So meter shows is around 55. So now we are connected to 310 mil. So into 2, it is a multiplication factor. So the voltage is 110 volts. So now increase the voltage. It is around 220 because it is here connected to 310 mil. So multiplication factor is 2. 110 into 2, which is equal to 220. The current through the network is 0.33 amperes. The voltage across the fluorescent lamp is 106 amperes. The voltage across the fluorescent lamp is 106 volts. Gradually decrease the voltage by using variac. We will observe the decrease in the brightness of the fluorescent lamp. Take down the corresponding readings by increasing the variac in steps of either 10 or 5 volts. After performing the test, slowly increase the zero position to the after performing the experiment, decrease the voltage zero by using variac to the zero position. MCB to the down circuit, switch off the main supply.